Monday, May 11th, our fifth grade class began the big challenge for Science by Mail's message in a bottle. Three teams would compete. Our challenge was to send a mystery rescue message to our stranded colleagues at three different places on the island. Codes had to be used because ruthless villains were waiting to intercept any message that would lead to our treasure. Crusaders planned to send a message through a code they made up, but soon realized you can't yell a mile. Then they used a pulley to send the message back in a code called Shonoglyphics. Shonoglyphics was made up by one of the members.
While everybody was getting ready for school. years ago in an automobile accident. It took a while to get over it, but life goes on. I remember it like it was yesterday. It was back to school night, and me and my mother were gone. When it came our turn to talk to Mr. Conway, he told me that there was going to be a career contest, and the winner got the picture put in the newspaper. So I went home that night and tried my very best to figure out something to do. I went through magazines and newspapers to come up with an idea. Finally, I came up with a veterinarian. I could not wait until Friday, because that was the day that we told Mr. Chang what we were going to be doing. When it came Lorraine's turn to say, she's a girl in my class, and also as my neighbor, said she was going to be doing a social worker, and she would be interviewing her parents, because both of her parents were social workers. Well, I thought for sure she was going to win. When it came my turn, I told him I was going to do a veterinarian, and he asked me if I knew anybody that was a veterinarian, and I said no. A boy in my class named Mike raised his hand and said that both of his parents were veterinarians, and probably wouldn't mind if I came and interviewed them. Lorraine, who liked Mike at the time, raised her hand and asked if she could do something else because she was jealous. Mr. Chang said that she had a perfectly good thing and she didn't need to change it. When it came Monday to come back to school, Lorraine came bragging and was telling me that Mike invited her to an open house in his house and that her family was going. Well, I was sort of jealous, and I was upset too because me and Mike became good friends whenever I was being interviewing his parents. Well, finally, every time the mail came, I tried to go and I'd see if we got an invitation. Finally, we did, and I couldn't wait to brag to Lorraine that I got one too. I went over to my friend Sarah's house, and her mother is divorced and is dating now, and my mother isn't. So we were looking through the newspaper, and we came up to call the singles dating line. I called and pretended I was my mother. That wasn't very good, because every time the phone rang, I had to run to the phone and answer it before my mother could, and my mother started suspecting things. If you want to find out what else happened, you should read this book. I really enjoyed it, and it's a good book to read.
Believe it. is really jam-packed.
Talk louder.
Another surprise. We were on a two-dimensional planet, but not for very long. We couldn't breathe.
know I'm not going to talk to either of my parents. So, let's write a race. Hello? Oh, hi, Dad. I gotta go. Can you talk to Bruce real quick? Bruce! That's my younger brother. Bruce! Oh, Dad, I'm in the shower. I didn't want to lie to Dad. I didn't go get a shower, but all right. So I went to go visit my friends at the pond the next day. I told them what happened. They couldn't believe it either. So then I go to LA with my father. I find out he has a girlfriend named Iris. I was stunned, and she's real nice, and she's skinny. But she's not like most of the girls in LA. She's not a blonde and tan, real skinny lady on the beach all the time. So she's okay. But it really bugs me to think that my dad has another girlfriend. So I went to Rachel's the next day. She has two cats, Bert and Harry. So they snuggled up and they started praying. I fell asleep on her bed. When I woke up, they were done eating dinner already. So I went home. I went to bed. Above my bed, I have a poster of a guy. His name is Chris, but I call him Benjamin more because I like the name after the paint. Well, I've got to go. But if you want to find a lot more about me and my friends, you can read this book called Just As Long As We're Together by Judy Wood.
She had to go out and clean all the toilet paper off the trees in her house. And then she heard her boyfriend keep his brakes on his bicycle, and he came beside her and started cleaning up the mess. And she went inside to get some hot chocolate, and she didn't know how to get rid of him. So she had this makeup case, and she pretended that she put it on her and made herself look like she had all bruises all over. And so she came out, and then he had to get her, and she gave him chocolate cocoa, and then he went home. And then the next day, she knew that she couldn't take off the bruises, because then Keith didn't know that she was lying to him. So she just covered it up with her sister's makeup. And then she went to cheerleader practice. And then when she was sweating, she took the makeup came off, and it looked like she was bleeding. And everybody said, "Look, that's bleeding." So she ran into the bathroom and cleaned herself up. After that, she went home, and
to your mom. Mom, you know what Albert says? He says there's a thing called winter and then we shrivel up and die. Well, I'm afraid it's true, honey. Well, Mom, why didn't you tell me about it? Well, I didn't think you were ready for it. Well, I'm not gonna sleep half of my life. I'm gonna go somewhere else. I'll go to California or something. Then, about 2 days later, her friend came to visit. His name was the Moth Child, and he was a moth. He bragged a lot because he could fly and everything. She told him about her situation, that about winter and everything, and he says, well, you don't have to hibernate. Come with me to the top of the Empire State Building, and you can stay up all night and all day and for the whole winter, because there's lights up there and they keep you warm, and you won't shrivel up and die. So then she made up her mind and she was going to go. She asked me if I wanted to go, but I just couldn't. I've been here so long, I couldn't leave my home.
Mr. Commissioner, what are you doing with the gun in your hand? I'm gonna shoot you, Batman. You have caused enough trouble in Gotham City.
What?
I have not done anything to bother you. Yes, you have. What? Tell me one thing.
Well, I don't know.
Maybe you can try to name just one.
Well, I gotta think about it.
But I'm just trying to be friends with you, Batman. Wait, Commissioner, I haven't done anything to harm you or anything like that. Yes, you have. You have two of my friends. Some of my friends. No, I haven't. You
committed some murders to kill people. You even made a truck run over one of my friends. Well, that was an accident. The man was running. He was scared of me. Well, that's too bad. No! My father and my mother have died already. Now you're gonna kill me, the one and only Batman? Find out what happens to the Batman and whether the commissioner tries to kill him, you have to read The Untold Legend of the Batman.
Somebody is trying to sell a necklace at this party, and her old roommate, Miss Stark, comes up and asks her if she can just wear it for a few minutes. And then after that, she goes up and she asks if she said she was feeling ill. So she goes up to the bedroom and she lays down and locks the door. And then the lady sends up a guard to Then she hear her scream, and two gunshots were fired off. And then after that, the guard broke down the door. He ran in, and he saw that she was in a faint. And then he asked what was wrong. And he asked, did she see the thief? And she said, no, it happened so quickly. So she was rushed to the hospital. And then after that, Encyclopedia's father told him what had happened, and he tried to figure out the case, and he said that it was Miss Stark that was trying to steal it. He told the Sergeant Murphy to go up to that room and search for the gun and necklace that had been fired, and they searched it, and they, she screamed before the gunshot was fired. They found out that she was trying to steal the necklace, and they sent back a sergeant to see for the necklace and the gun. And they found it up in her closet, so they found out that it was her, that Miss Stark, that was trying to steal the necklace. And they knew it was her also because the windows weren't open and nothing was shot out.
The book I read was Henry Incorporated, and it was about this boy named Henry, and he liked to make schemes to make money. So one day he went to the state to visit his aunt and uncle. And about 1 or 2 weeks he opened a little business called Henry Incorporated. And he sold worms, pigeons, and rabbits. And one day his dog was chasing rabbit that he saw, and then the rabbit went in the old pipe, and the dog went after it, and the dog got stuck. So Mitch, his friend, went up looking at some construction workers up the road, fixing the road. So Midge ran up there and got the construction workers and told me. So then Midge came back with the construction workers and it was so about the guys got carved up. So they tore off the road and got the pipe and then got a little crane, was up in the dock and tumbling out. Then they placed the pipe and then they got the dog out. You know how long in the story, they were walking down the street and they saw some construction workers drilling for some water. And he said, no, Marwich drilling. He said, because we're going to make a house there and he was drilling for some water. And then we asked them if they knew if there's any water there. We said, no, they just guessed. And so then Henry went on to tell him about people grind rice sticks and find oil. So one day Henry and Midge decided to try that, and Midge was walking around and she felt a strong pull on the stick. So Henry and Midge did a drill and we let it drill down and when it got to a certain point, it stopped. So he lifted up and dropped it a couple of times and finally broke through. Now these newspaper reporters came by and asked how they know that it's oil. And then they told them about it. Then the apples came over, which will mean if they set a foot on the land, they had to tell their parents. So they came over and, Mr. Apple said, I know that oil tank was put there. It was a long time ago when we were starting to build a house. So the sunification was almost over and Henry went back to Naples, Italy. And he started school again to find more details and more adventures that I had in this book, Henry and the Cold Lady.
And I like that. And then after that day, I heard
heard that Norma told her friends that she would take all of her friends to a concert, the band, the Brain Damage, to everybody she knew as her friends, except Fabulous Five in the front row of the concert. And she, and Beth, she had a plan to stop them from going there. So she took all the girls that her friend Jana Morgan was a distant cousin from Trevor Morgan, the head of Brain Damage. So everybody was talking Jana Morgan, things like that. The next day she went. She called the hotel they were staying at and said if she could talk to them, but they said no. So she dressed up as an Indian and went there instead. And then when she was in their room, she said that if he could come to Bumpers after school and sign everybody's autograph, because that's what they all wanted her to do. But he said he couldn't because he was busy, but he knew something else he could do. So at the concert, and he said, after he sang, he said that he'd like to thank the Fabulous Five, and then they went up and sang a song. Then after that, she went back to school and everything was okay. And then she had to pretend that she was married to somebody in her classroom, and they had to bring a doll in. Things I read in writing work would be just as fine as if you read it.
It didn't record it.